an explorer encounters an ancient tribe with advanced knowledge of the cosmos. The tribe claimed their knowledge is a gift from celestial visitors hundreds of years ago. In 1931. After trekking for hundreds of miles through the jungles of sub-Saharan Africa, French anthropologist Marcel Grioul reaches the country of Mali. There, he and his team meet with local tribespeople known as the Dogon. The existence of the companion star, called Sirius B, had been established by astronomers several decades before Grioul's arrival. This leads some to suggest that perhaps other traders or visitors had revealed its existence to the Dogon.
The really strange thing about the Dogon tradition is that it dates back to before the era of astronomical instruments. The knowledge existed for many centuries before Sirius B was even known.
During his time with the Dogon, Grioul observes them conducting strange rituals to mark the passage of the invisible star. Even though they cannot see it, they seem to be able to predict its movement.
So they also got the orbital period correct, 50 years. So how could they know that?
If you were to look at a modern drawing of the orbits of Sirius and Sirius B and compare that to the ancient Dogon drawing, you'll see that they match up almost identically.
The remote tribe appear to understand the orbital mechanisms of a star almost 9 light years from Earth. Some dismiss this as pure coincidence. Dumb luck might explain 2 correct astronomical predictions, but the Dogon legend also reveal a 3rd prophecy about Sirius B. They claim that it is white and made from the heaviest metal in the universe.
One thing they said about Sirius B is that it's made up of very, very heavy, very dense material.
For 7 decades, scientists can only speculate as to how much of the Dogon's astronomical knowledge is true. In 2005, NASA begins deep space observations of Sirius B using the Hubble Space Telescope. The state-of-the-art satellite data shows that, incredibly, the Dogon were right once again.
NASA's Hubble Space Telescope finally gets us the information we need. Sirius B is a white dwarf star. It's a dead star that's incredibly dense. 1 teaspoon would weigh over 1 ton.
The NASA discovery seems to confirm that the ancient tribespeople have somehow acquired detailed information about a star that is invisible to them.
So how did they come to this knowledge, which we observe to be true in large part? The Dogon claim that they received the information about Sirius B directly from beings who lived in that star system.
The Dogon tell Grioul that these celestial beings visited their ancestors many generations ago. They honor them with ritualistic mass dances. They call them the Teachers.
The Teachers have come to Earth sometime in the past to teach them things that they would otherwise not know.
According to the Dogon, the Teachers live on a 3rd star near Sirius B. This 3rd star has yet to be discovered. But gravitational studies of the star system suggest that it might exist.
We can actually scientifically examine the idea that there's this 3rd star in the Sirius system. And a paper was published in 1995 that showed that perhaps there is a 3rd companion star, and it has an orbit of about 6 years.
The existence of the 3rd star remains unconfirmed. The search for the origin of the Dogon's mysterious astronomical knowledge continues.
It sounds like something straight out of a sci-fi movie, but in fact, there may be some truth to it.
Coming up, the U.S. military intercepts man-made signals coming from the moon 2 decades before the first lunar landings.
German rocket technology and second half, in particular, World War II, was shockingly advanced.
I really wonder if the Germans could have gotten to the moon. Actually, I think they could have.
A NASA probe captures an image of a weirdly familiar structure on the surface of Mars. September 25th, 2012. NASA's $720 million Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter circles 170 miles above the red planet. Its state-of-the-art high-rise camera captures a remarkable image.
This reminds me very much of something we have right here on Earth. And that something is Stonehenge.
If I wasn't mistaken, I would say I'm looking at an aerial satellite image of Stonehenge. They both have concentric circles with a square or a rectangle in the middle. That's exactly what I'm looking at here.
The famous circle at Stonehenge is more than 5,000 years old and has mystified archaeologists for centuries. At this sacred place, pagan priests of ancient Druid cults communed with the stars.
Are we looking at something that might be the equivalent of Stonehenge on Mars, a Marshenge?
You have to ask yourself, is this evidence of civilization on Mars?
To date, there is no evidence to support the existence of monument builders on Mars. Some planetary scientists have a more natural explanation for Marshenge.
On Earth, whenever we see unusual rock formations, you know, the geologists will consider that maybe they've been shaped or influenced by seismic activity.
But there's a big problem with the Marsquake theory.
We don't know if Mars has Marsquakes. We've never made the measurement. You know, we don't know if the interior of Mars is active like the interior of the Earth.
Another possible clue to the origin of Marshenge could come from a strange phenomenon on our own planet in Death Valley, California.
Here on Earth in Death Valley, for instance, there are rocks that seem to just move on their own. And we know what that's from. There's ice underneath the rocks, and winds propel them very slowly across the desert, leaving little trails. So the question is, could this be happening on Mars?
Astronomers have found evidence that ice can form on Mars. But close analysis of the image suggests that it cannot account for the arrangement of the Marshenge boulders.
These rocks are sitting up on top of a peak, and it would take a lot of wind to move a rock on a lot of ice to get it up on top of a peak like this. And on Mars, we don't have air that's dense enough to make that much of a forceful wind that could drive a giant boulder.
The giant boulders were not, it seems, pushed there by Martian winds. A different theory suggests the rocks might not be from Mars at all.
Mars is constantly being bombarded by meteorites. There are impact craters all across its surface. Is it possible that this structure is the result of a cratering event?
Image analysis seems to support this idea.
If we zoom out a little more, we see there's actually a larger circular pattern. Now, what is that? Maybe this is a sediment-filled crater.
NASA calculates that around 200 asteroids smash into the red planet every year. Could one of these impacts have created Marshenge?
It's unlikely that a large impact would leave a collection of large boulders at the bottom of the crater. If it was a large enough asteroid to make a crater, that asteroid would actually break up into smaller and smaller pieces, and you would see the ejecta outside the crater. And that's not what we see in this case.
In 2020, NASA will send a next-generation rover to explore the Martian surface. One of its objectives is to investigate the geological processes that created the red planet's strange landscape. Until then, the origin of the mysterious Marshenge will remain unexplained.
This is one of those cases where we probably won't know the answer to how this rock formation formed until we get on the ground at that location.